Red light.
It is on. Thank God. All right, here we go. And go. Oh, this place is so homey and relaxing. Nice. Hey.
Hey.
What's your problem?
What's my problem?
Excuse me. I mean, what do you think? You own the place?
Yeah, I do think I own the place. I'm happy that you're comfortable, but you're a little too comfortable, dude.
Your Penny. Penny, who owns Cool Beans, where we are right now.
Hi.
Hello, Penny.
Hello. How are you?
Thank you for throwing me off the couch.
And, you're quite welcome. And thank you for lounging.
No, this is very cozy, very comfy. I mean, I love it. Cool Beans. Why did you call it Cool Beans? What was the origin?
Cool Beans is an old term I picked up when I had a job down in Florida. I met a girl who was from down south, and she said Cool Beans. And it stuck. It stuck, and I've heard other people say it in different places, but I'm the one who usually says it all the time, and then when it came time to have a coffee shop, it made sense.
What was the reason for starting at Sunnyside? You mentioned, you know, the origin was from Florida. What is it?
No, it's not a Florida connection. It's a Queens connection. Sunnyside is, you know, I've been here for 25 years. I love this neighborhood. Basically, it's Mayberry. It's the Mayberry of New York City.
Now, when did you open? Now, I mean, look, we're in the middle of a pandemic. We're in the middle of a bit of a crisis here.
Yeah.
How did that affect the opening of the restaurant and any delays? I mean, what happened?
It affected it greatly. I actually came across this property in September of 2019 and got all of this together, hoping to open by February of 2020, and then the pandemic came. So I actually had to sit and wait until September of 2020. I waited a whole year to be able to open.
I was gonna say, I mean, it's nerve-wracking for someone putting all this heart and passion into something that's as beautiful as this, and then having that happen.
Yeah. But it's, you know, everybody's going through something, aren't they? And 25 for Sunnyside, I have to say, has just pulled us along. I don't know actually where I would be without this group.
Let's talk about food. I want to hear a little bit more about their food and stuff like that. Can we go take a look and see what we got?
There over here in the kitchen is my cook. This is Christy.
Christy,
guys,
come on over.
Christy's my guy.
Christy, when we walked in the place, we smelled the paninis.
Oh, Ryan.
And I were like just very excited. Tell us a little bit about the paninis.
Oh, we specialize. We do a lot of specialty sandwiches. We do a great hot roast beef with cheddar, caramelized onion, horseradish mayonnaise. We do a Sunnyside Cuban for Sunnyside. It's ham, turkey, Swiss cheese, mustard, pickles on a roll, and it's pressed on the panini press. We also have what we call the Woodside Chicken. It's a grilled chicken breast with pesto sauce, provolone cheese, and roasted red pepper. That's put on the press as well. We do a Reuben Rachel, which is a version of a Reuben sandwich, only we substitute turkey to be a little healthier. Instead of the corned beef. We do breakfast sandwiches. We do breakfast all day.
That is actually our biggest hit, truthfully, is that all day breakfast. There aren't many places to get a breakfast sandwich.
Yeah.
Just eggs and bacon or ham or sausage on a roll. Very, very simple. And that's the one that we sell all day, every day.
Now, I also see, too, you just bought a breakfast. You got muffins. Yeah. You got all kinds of stuff like that. Everything's freshly baked daily?
Everything is freshly baked daily. I get my bakery products from Davidovich Bakery, who is also located here in Woodside, and I put in an order every day by 3 o'clock, and they get here about 3 a.m, 12 hours later, and I come in. It's every day is Christmas, so you can always be assured that what you're getting is absolutely fresh.
All righty, the big walking scene there, folks.
Yeah.
We're exhausted.
A lot of walking.
These are adorable. I want to talk about this. I saw this when we walked in. Is this a local artist that did these? And it clearly is all interpretations of Sunnyside. Tell me about it.
These are taken from actual photos of Sunnyside from the past. The woman that I worked with who put together the design in the room, Katarina Midovich, she found photos online and cast them onto a gel and then penciled them or inked them, and then watercolored them in. They're absolutely beautiful. You can see there's quite a few of Phipps. That's the gardens inside Phipps. This is across the street.
I recognize this one. It's our producer Brian's apartment doorway. Well, he won't get a close up of that because he doesn't want you to know where he lives.
Yeah, so anybody who's stalking Brian, come
right.
on down, and
that
I will point
setting
you out.
Herself for him.
You know? They're absolutely beautiful. They get a great deal of attention when people come in and they're waiting on their coffee and pastries to be brought up to them.
Are you going to be featuring other artists and things like that? Is that the projection?
The projection in the future, yes, absolutely. I'd be more than happy to discuss it with them. This is such an artistic neighborhood. Everybody here is either an actor, a singer, a dancer, or an artist, a painter. So, of course, I would be more than happy to display some artwork when we get there.
I can also see something like, I don't know if you thought about this, but, you know, some kind of music scene for you or something like that, like an acoustic, you know, brunch or something.
I envision that as well. I envision a couple of guitars just sitting and strumming and hanging out in the evening times.
You know, great. Speaking of music, it's time for our ridiculous question of the week, and I already got a question in my head. Most influential band on music, is it A, the Beatles, or B, the Partridge Family? Go.
Wow, that's quite... Yeah. I thought it was going to be the Beatles or Elvis question, but that's not off the wall enough.
Partridge Family or Beatles, what do you say?
Well, there would be no Partridge Family if it wasn't for the Beatles, right? So... It's got to be the Beatles by default, but, you know, I love the Partridge Family. Who doesn't love some David Cassidy?
Well, I mean, you got to love David Cassidy. I mean, he was my idol. Penny, thank you so much for having us over.
My pleasure. Cool Beans. Thank you for coming to Cool Beans.
Thank you for coming to the neighborhood, and we wish you great success.
Thank you very much.
You're awesome. All right, guys, for 25 for Sunnyside Woodside, this is Ty saying bye-bye. Bye local.